Located in the middle of Main Street, it's Disney's House of Mouse.
Who's that knocking at the House of Mouse? We're all knocking at the House of Mouse. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're all rocking at the House of Mouse. We're having a ball and rocking the hall. So come on in,
to the House of Mouse.
Fun makes you jump and shout. Hey, little girl, I wanna dance with you. We'll find so many things to do. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're having a ball
at the House of Mouse. And now, Mickey Mouse.
Hello, Main Street. Thanks for coming out. Today's show is gonna be a real hoot.
We'll be the judge of that.
Now, let's kick it off with Huey, Dewey, and Louie. The Flash Report. Minnie, want to go for a pizza after the show?
Sure, Mickey. If we have a show, my computer won't work. I can't get the schedule or anything.
Well, here, let me help you with that.
Oh, no, that's okay. I'll ask Professor Von Drake. He'll know what to do.
That know-it-all?
Why, Mickey Mouse, I do believe you're jealous.
The brilliant Professor Von Drake, and that's me, has cognized the confounding conundrum you got there with your little mini computer, Minnie. The problem is D to the E plus A to the D. Your batteries is dead.
Huh, I could have told you that.
Yes, you could have, but you didn't have.
You really think you know it all, don't you?
Well, it has been proven in laboratory tests.
Well, you can't know everything, Professor. Gee, nobody knows everything.
Oh, would you care to back that up with a little wager?
You got it, smarty pants. Here's one shiny penny that says you don't know it all.
Well, spend your last great moment with Mr. Lincoln there, because... from the most profound proverb to the teensy-tiniest trivia, Von Drake knows it all.
Ooh, you can't know everything, and I'm gonna prove it.
And I'll help.
Oh, me too. I don't know much, but I know I can't stand to know it all.
Bring it on.
My line.
Well, I got one for you, know it all. Tell me what cartoon is coming up next.
My infallible statistical probability calculations have deduced Hydro Squirter.
Lucky guess.
Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two.
Oh, always with the twos, it's sticking. How am I ever going to get my personal rocket transporter off the ground? If the one thing wrong with it is that it can't even count to one.
Two.
This problem's going to require a lot of thinking. And in order to do the thinking, I'm going to need my thinking cap, which fortunately just happens to be my shower cap. Yes, there's no better place to doing genius thinking than in your shower. Not only is you getting the ideas, but you're also getting wet with all that water and the soapy business. Oh, nuts. What's with the cookie water not running? Maybe what we got here is a spigot on the fritz. Oh, that hot water there's got me hot under the collar. But not for long. The professor's gonna show this old tub who's boss once and for always. Introducing the Von Drake bathtub shower for the genius thinking and the solving of the problems. The first thing I gotta think about in there is a shorter name. Anyway, this little baby here's got it all. Hydromatic water jets, self-adjusting hot and cold running nozzles. We even got the mechanized automatic curtain mover. And an alarm system to scare away marauding bath burglars. Beautiful. Now the professor can get to his thinking. First, I gotta switch off the alarm. And now I'm gonna get with the rubber ducky here for a wonderful, relaxing, genius thinking shower. I just gotta turn on the water. Oh, not a delivery now. Always when you're in the shower. Righty, keep your bloomers from bunching. I heard a home delivery, but I didn't know they drove right into your home. Yikes! How did I get all the way out here in only my tail feathers? Somehow, I must have turned my shower into a teleport machine. Who that's quite ingenious of me, isn't it? Oh, drat, I forgot to set the alarm. Ah, come back here with my tub, you shower shoplifters, you. Ooh, boy, what a miscalculation I had. Just a little adjustment here, and I'll be right back to home. Oh, that's better. Home sweet lab. Stupid shower! If I wasn't already in the lake, I'd tell you to go jump in it! Come back here! You not a sink, you a tub! All right, now why is my tub not at home? Oh, would you look at that view? And look at that roller coaster! Wow, wow, wow! All right. I've had it with you, you cast-iron water bucket. From now on, I'm walking on my own feet.
Step away from the top, you cookie criminal, you. This is not a warning. Well, actually, it is a warning, but you know what I mean.
Oh, that's it. I'm all washed up. My Von Drake bathtub shower for the genius thinking and the solving of the problems is a failure. Sorry.
What's the big idea?
Hey, get off my coffee table.
Well, what do you know? No lakes, no roller coaster, no lions. Just my lab, sweet lab. And you want to know something? I actually cooked up an idea about how to fix that rocket with the sticking tools.
Two.
All right, that's it. Woohoo! Now I don't have to worry about either problem, because they both gone. And I'm still a genius. And nobody would ever know something went wrong. Hello? Oh, hello there, Mickey. How you doing? Oh, no, I don't know nothing about a big rocket in the bathtub, and you've got the wrong number. Goodbye. Woo, what a tremendous cartoon picture. Positively dripping with comedy. Dripping.
I got one little stump here, Professor. How long does it take Tinkerbell to fly from Never Never Land to London in a 40-mile-an-hour headwind with one wing?
2 hours, 45 minutes. If she never, never lands. That's funny. Never, never lands. Oh, that's good.
Bet you can't answer this one. Whose autograph is this?
That, my dear, is Captain Hook's handwriting. Or rather, Hook writing.
Odds fish, I've sailed the seven seas and never spied such a clever duck. Now where'd I leave my notepad?
Have you checked your hat?
My hat? Nope. There's an idea. Yummy, but no. Gosh, it's not even mine. Well, here it is. Now where's my hat?
Okay, how many golden camels did Prince Ali Ababa bring with him into Agrabah?
That would be 75. Of course I know what it needs. Just a spoonful of sugar. Sorry, fellas, but practical pig's right. Go with the brick house. Well, that belongs to Cinderella. You should pop in sometime. She's on Big Castle Boulevard. Snow White is the fairest of them all.
Which file? Which file?
What kind of day is it? It's a brazzle-dazzle day, of course. Oh, I'd say everyone is afraid of the big bad you.
But when, Professor? What day should I expect him?
Sunday. Your prince will come.
Excuse me for interrupting, Professor.
Well, Mickey, you got another difficult question for the professor? Oh, I'm so scared.
Oh, yeah? Well, spell supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
SUPERCALIFRAGILISTICEXPIALIDOCIODS.
Oh, Mickey, just give him his penny and call it a day.
Ooh, there's gotta be something he doesn't know. How could you possibly know it all? Your head isn't that big.
Calm down there, Mickey. Oh, you're so uptight. Lucky for you, this next cartoon, which of course I already know what it is, will tranquilize your temper, Tizzy, and put your little mousy mind in a mellow mood.
What's the big idea?
Professor Ludwig von Drake, all-around genius and expert on stress reduction. And what we got here is my anxiety-ridden nephew. He's got a lot of unresolved psychological baggage and a really bad temper as a carry-on. But not to worry. Today we're going to use the von Drake method to calm him down. No, with the latest in alternative relaxation hocus pocuses, we're gonna make his caboose as loose as a goose on an obtuse hypotenuse.
Now that's more like it.
To relax the patient, we gotta create a calming atmosphere by soothing all the senses. Sight, touch, hearing, smell, and taste. Complete darkness is the best way to relax the peepers. For this, we're gonna use the von Drake Darkness Helmet.
Hey, where'd everybody go?
Secondly, we got to keep the patient warm and toasty. That's right. And there's nothing so relaxing to the ears than the sounds of the whale songs.
She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. She'll be coming around the mountain when she comes. I've been working on the railroad all the livelong time. Oh, Susanna, don't you cry for me, 'cause I come from Panama with the banjo on my knee.
Now for the nose, because your nose knows the difference between a rose and your toes. For this, I got an aroma diploma from PU.
Oh, brother.
Now, aromatherapy uses different smells to relax the mind and the body.
That smells good.
You know, this aromatherapy stuff doesn't come cheap. He's not just tense, he's past tense. We gotta change his diet and get him eating right, all right?
Eating? Oh, boy!
A little chamomile tea will soothe this one's tired nerves.
Yuck!
There now, that's a good boy.
That's a big idea, I'll show ya.
Now for some B vitamin. Now remember, don't take too many or you could get hives. I can't believe that he's still tense. Which is why we got this here biofeedback machine. It makes the patient aware of how unrelaxed he is by measuring his stress vibrations and feeding them back as electrical energy.
Electrical? Get that out.
The tingling means it's working. All right. Now that his rump has been roasted, the subject is closer to a blissful state of relaxation. Now we're gonna untighten your uptight, not relaxing muscles. For this, we're gonna use my latest invention. The Von Drake Punch the Living Daylights Out of Your Machine.
I don't like the sound of that.
Or just click the remote control button, and the patient gets a wonderful, relaxing, punching, massage. Oh, just listen to that relaxing punching. Isn't it beautiful? It can also give you all types of massages, like the Swedish meatball massage. There's the sushi massage, the German pretzel massage, and my favorite, the origami massage. Looks like we made a swan out of that ugly duckling. Ooh, I gonna tell you, stress management is a very stressful job. Oh, so now I gonna show you how the professor relaxes. And nothing relaxes the professor more than a good brain puzzler. Now, you see, I built this thing over here. I don't even know what it is. Am I ever puzzled? Well, what do you know? I'm relaxed. Now it's back to work on the duck. When all else fails, we reach the point of the acupuncture therapy. This usually means using one pin at a time. But that takes too long. That's why the professor is using this acupuncture chamber.
I'm not going in there.
Sometimes the patient requires a little motivation. Now that's what I call one relaxed fella. All right, now that the treatment is complete, we are releasing the patient back into his environment to see how relaxed he has become. Isn't that marvelous? The patient is cool, calm, and collected, all because I'm the most brilliant relaxation therapist who ever lived. Look, he's come back to thank the professor.
I feel much better now.
Believe it or not, that was very relaxing. Oh, and a brilliant guest appearance by Willie the Whale.
Come on, Duck Lady, the show's almost over. Where's our table?
Oh, well, computer glitch. Now we don't know where anyone sits.
Hot dog, that's perfect.
Where does everyone sit? Let me see. We got Dumbo to the left, then we got Bendy to the right, then Cinderella and Cruella and Prince Charming and Snow White. Genie's next to Jasmine and Aladdin and his lamp, along with Peter Pan and Tinkerbell and Lady and the Prince. Here's Lumiere the Candlestick and Cogsworth Easter Clock. They're special, grumpy, sleepy, happy, sneezy, dopey duck. Table 9 has Ichabod, I'm Moby and Baloo. The head is Horseman's Table 7, and his head's at Table 2. Over here is Sleeping Beauty. Ooh, someone wake her up. On Beauty and the Beast, we got the teapot and the cup. Timon and Pumbaa, Little Mermaid and the sea witch in her shell. Quasimodo's next to Esmeralda, Beast is next to Belle. Captain Hook, now here's where he goes. And here's where Mr. Smee goes. Tweedledum and Tweedledee goes. Like the Army, three amigos. Pocahontas, get where she goes. By Roy Disney and where he goes. Cause movie stars have egos and you gotta treat them right. Manhattan's next to Alice, Peter Hart and Cheshire Cat, John Appleseed and Mr. Toad and Casey and his bat, Jimmy Cricket and Geppetto and Pinocchio, Little Elf, and Monstro in the corner gets a table to himself. We got Hercules, Philoctetes and Hades next to him, King Arthur's next to Merlin and Sir Case by Madam Mim, the Simba by Mufasa and Rafiki next to Scar, hey Little Pigs, the Big Bad Wolf, Iago and Jafar. Prince John, Cricky, Mushu, and Mulan. Here's Lafu, and there's Gaston. Then there's Khan, here's Shere Khan, and the crazy Aragorn. And here's Ranger Audubon. We got Wendy, Michael, John. I could just go on and on. Oh. Pink elephants, Brer Rabbit, and Brer Fox, and Brer Bear. Here's 100 cute Dalmatians. Look, they need another chair. Paul Bunyan and Chip and Dale, and then there's Kanga, and there's Ooh. Right next to Taylor, and to Piglet, and to Winnie, he's the Pooh. That's everyone. Well, Mickey, I think we've established exactly who is the know-it-all. Professor Ludwig von Drake is who? I've answered every last question. Now pay up.
Not so fast. You didn't name everyone. Huh? You forgot one.
What? That's impossible.
Ooh.
Who did the professor forgot?
Who? You.
Oh, boy.
Well, folks, that's about it for our show. Say, what question was it that started all this anyway? Oh, yeah. Hey, Minnie, want to go for a pizza?
Well, there's only one answer to that question. Of course.
Where do you want to go?
Oh, I don't know. Where do you want to go?
Well, that's what I was asking you.
Well, don't ask me. Don't you know where you want to go?
Oh, gosh, I don't know. I don't know anything.
Aw, that's okay. It's nice not knowing everything.
Here, and I have another knock-knock joke for you. Knock-knock, who's there? Opal. Opal who? Opal the door and let me in, it's locked. Yeah, oh, that's a doozy. Hey, wait, the door really is locked. Hello, anybody? Opal the door and let me in. Mouse.